Hello, my name is Cornelius Vanderbilt. I was born on May 27th, 1794. As a young lad, I worked for my father's ferry company, dropping out of school at only age 11. As I grew, I began to gain leadership positions and eventually invested in the ferry company. From there, my business only grew until I expanded into railroads. Railroads was what really made me all my money. And now I'm one of the richest moguls in America.
Mr. Vanderbilt, tell me about your home life as a mogul.
Obviously, I did not have the strongest upbringing, as I did have to drop out of school. But even though I was uneducated, I worked my way to the top and was quite wealthy. I married my first cousin, Sophia Johnson, at the age of 19, and we had 13 children together. And surprisingly, only one of them died.
You said that only one out of the 13 children you had died, is that correct?
Yes, that is quite true. My 10th youngest son, George Washington Vanderbilt, passed away in 1836 from a weak heart.
All right, let's see if that's correct. Bring him in.
Boy, I thought I buried you.
No. Here, I got this for you.
What did you do, boy? Go back to your coffin.
Please, sir, please. Give me some more water. I need it. I'm dying.
Anyways, let's move on to the next question.
What were some of your greatest accomplishments in your steamboat company?
Well, I had so many. It truly was a great start to my career. In the first place, I was working for a company called Gibbons and worked my way up to the top until I could buy my own line operating on the Hudson River. I quickly became one of the most important shippers in the Hudson River, delivering textiles from their manufacturers out to ports. Additionally, during the Civil War, I donated so graciously one of my steamboats called the Vanderbilt to be of service to the Union, and it actually hunted down some Confederate cruisers. For these actions, I was awarded a Congressional Medal of Honor.
All right, let's talk about your first wife, Sophia Johnson Vanderbilt.
Oh yes, as I previously mentioned, we got married when I was 19. She was not a, let's say, strong player in my building of my empire, but she did allow me to continue my bloodline, so for that I do appreciate her.
And we heard some rumors that Sophia was related to you?
Oh, I believe those may be true. We like to keep it close in my family, make sure the blood is as pure as it can be.
I'm so sorry for your loss, but what was life like without Sophia?
Well, obviously I was crushed when Sophia died in 1968, but my children needed a mother. So, naturally, I waited a year and got married to Frank Armstrong Crawford. She was actually my cousin's daughter, and I will say she did do good things for my name. You know Vanderbilt University? Guess who created it? Yes, that's true. I built it in Tennessee because I saw it as reparations to the Confederates after what I did to them with my steamboats, and now it is one of the most successful universities in the country.
Here to report on this, we bring in both the wives of Cornelius Vanderbilt.
Both?
Cornelius, my love.
Frank, hello.
Cornelius!
Sophia, I thought you were dead.
Who is she?
Who are you?
This is my wife.
I'm your wife?
No, you are
not.
I'm his wife.
I'm his first cousin.
Oh, well, screw that. We're in love.
You ugly wench!
You!
Stop running!
Moving on. Let's talk about some of my railroad adventures.
Yes, of course. Remind us again how many you owned?
I own 13, many of which are still owned by my family, operating across New York, Ohio, much of the Midwest, some of the South, and much of the Northeast.
All right, Mr. Cornelius, can you go into more detail about your future ancestry and what they did as Vanderbilts?
Red, just possessing lineage to me has already set up many people for success, as I am one of the largest families in America, both economy and with people. Some notable people you might know are from the 21st century. Anderson Cooper is a reporter for CNN. Guess who he's related to? Additionally, his mother was a very notable fashion designer, and I was proud to call her my relative. My family is still prosperous and still manages the railroads which I started. We like to keep things in the family in more than one way here.
To wrap up our interview, Cornelius, do you believe that you should be remembered as a robber baron or a captain of industry?
Oh, that's a great question. I believe that I should be remembered as a captain of industry because what I did for the American people was astounding. I developed many of the railways that we are now dependent on, as well as helping grow some of the waterways. Additionally, I created a university. I have done more for the American people than many other moguls, and I am so benevolent to my country that I can only be seen as captain of industry.
Controlled by Cornelius Vanderbilt, this being one of many.
My most successful railways were actually in New York. Grand Central Station is a subway force that is still around today. I created it with the hopes of intersecting my Harlem and New York lines. I love these railways more than I love life itself.
Father, what about us?
What about
his father? What are you doing? It's murder on the dance floor. But you better not kill the groove, DJ. Gonna burn this goddamn house right down. Oh, I know. About your.
Railroad in your life, boy.
No, I haven't. Oh, it hurts so bad.
What are you fools doing? There are railroads to be built. Like the three days. No, Peter. Foolish children. Imbeciles.
Just love us.
Who are you? I don't know you.
You're terrible, secretly absent father.
About.
How do you feel about this whole interview?
It has been an interesting one.
I can't hear you, boy!
Your life sucks!
Don't call me a boy!
Cornelius Vanderbilt!
Catch me, father!
Ow, mother!
Thanks for watching!
Ha ha ha.